second readings. And we commence with the lighting of the first Advent candle. Jesus Christ is the light of the world.
The light no darkness can overcome.
Stay with us, Lord, for it is evening.
And the day is almost over.
Let your light scatter the darkness.
And illumine to the church.
The Spirit and the church cry out,
Come, Lord Jesus.
All those who await his appearance pray,
Come, Lord Jesus.
The whole creation pleads,
Come, Lord Jesus.
And now we're going to listen to the Advent prose, which is going to be sung by Robin Hell.
The Holy One.
in accounts of prophecy and fulfillment that directs our attention to Jesus Christ. Illumine us now as we hear your word proclaimed, that we may open our hearts to him, yearn for his coming in glory, and serve him with joy. Our reader this evening is Patricia Butler, and she's now going to bring us the first reading.
The first reading, entitled God's Promise to Those Who Wait, is taken from Isaiah chapter 64, verses 1 to 9. Oh, that you would tear open the heavens and come down, so that the mountains would quake at your presence. As when fire kindles brushwood and the fire causes water to boil, to make your name known to your adversaries, so that the nations might tremble at your presence. When you did awesome deeds that we did not expect, you came down. The mountains quaked in your presence. From ages past, no one has heard, no ear has perceived, no eye has seen any God besides you, who works for those who wait for him. You meet those who gladly do right, those who remember you in your ways. But you are angry and we sinned. Because you hid yourself, we transgressed. We have all become like one who is unclean, and all our righteous deeds are like a filthy cloth. We all fade like a leaf, and our iniquities, like the wind, take us away. There is no one who calls on your name or attempts to take hold of you, for you have hidden your face from us and have delivered us into the hand of our iniquity. Yet, O Lord, you are our Father, and we are in the clay, and you are our potter. We are all the work of your hand. Do not be exceedingly angry, O Lord, and do not remember iniquity forever. Now consider, we are all your no eye has seen any God besides you,
who works for those who wait for him.
Eternal God, through long generations you prepared a way for the coming of your Son, and by your Spirit you still bring light to illumine our paths. Renew us in faith and hope, that we may welcome Christ to rule our cause and claim our love, to whom be glory forever.
Amen.
Now Scott Gould is going to sing, Christ be our light.
Longing for light, we wait in darkness.
Faithful God, whose promises stand unshaken throughout all generations, renew us in hope that we may be awake and alert, watching for the glorious return of Jesus Christ, our Judge and Savior, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
Oh, yeah.
Gospel reading, the birth of Jesus foretold. Come, Lord, do not delay. Forgive the sins of your people. Come to us, Lord, with your peace, that we may rejoice in your presence with sincerity of heart. Look, the Lord will come to save his people.
Blessed are those who are ready to meet him.
Hear the Gospel of our Savior Christ, according to St. Luke, chapter 1, beginning at verse 26.
Glory to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
In the sixth month, the angel Gabriel was sent by God to a town in Galilee called Nazareth, to a virgin engaged to a man whose name was Joseph of the house of David. The virgin's name was Mary, and he came to her and said, "Greetings, favored one, the Lord is with you." But she was much perplexed by his words and pondered what sort of greeting this might be. The angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. And now you will conceive in your womb and bear a son, and you will name him Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High. And the Lord God will give to him the throne of his ancestor David. He will reign over the house of Jacob forever, and of his kingdom there will be no end." Mary said to the angel, "How can this be, since I am a virgin?" The angel said to her, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. Therefore the child to be born will be holy. He will be called Son of God. And now your relative Elizabeth, in her old age, has also conceived a son. And this is the sixth month for her who was said to be barren. For nothing will be impossible with God." Then Mary said, "Here am I, the servant of the Lord. Let it be with me according to your word." Then the angel departed from her. This is the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Let us pray. Gracious God, whose eternal word took flesh among us, when Mary placed her life at the service of your will, prepare our hearts for his coming again, and keep us steadfast in hope, that we may be ready for the coming of his kingdom, for his sake who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen.
Amen.
Blessed are you, O Lord our God, ruler of the universe, creator of light and darkness. In this holy season, when the sun's light is swallowed up by the growing darkness of the night, you renew your promise to reveal among us the splendor of your glory, made flesh and visible to us in Jesus Christ, your Son. Through the prophets, you teach us to hope for his reign of peace. Through the outpouring of your Spirit, you give sight to our souls, that we may see your glory in the presence of Christ. Strengthen us where we are weak. Support us in our efforts to do your will, and free our tongues to pray, sing your praise, for to you all honor and blessing are due, now and forever.
Amen. Amen.
And now a collect prayer to sum up what we've been hearing about Advent. Almighty God, give us grace to cast away the works of darkness, and to put on the armor of light, now in the time of this mortal life, in which your Son, Jesus Christ, came to us in great humility, that on the last day, when he shall come again in his glorious majesty to judge the living and the dead, we may rise to the life immortal, through him who is alive and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.
Amen.
Thank you.
May God the Father, Judge all merciful, make us worthy of a place in his kingdom.
Amen.
May God the Son, coming among us in power, reveal in our midst the promise of his glory. Amen.
Amen.
May God the Holy Spirit make us steadfast in faith, joyful in hope, and constant in love.
Amen. Amen.
As we await our coming Savior, go in the peace of God.
Thanks be to God.